हेलो स्टूडेंट, इन टुडे सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द रिलेटिव पोर मेथड। हाउ द रिलेटिव पोर मेथड इज यूज टू सिंथेसाइज और टू फाइंड आउट द डाइमेंशंस ऑफ द स्लाइडर क्रैक मैकेनिज्म। ओके, इन लास्ट सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस दैट सेम मेथड, रिलेटिव पोर मेथड फॉर अ फोर बार चेन मैकेनिज्म। हियर वी विल डिस्कस द थ्री पोजिशन फॉर अ स्लाइडर क्रैक मैकेनिज्म। ओके, सो व्हाट इज स्लाइडर क्रैक मैकेनिज्म? If we see here is the fixed link, this is a crank, this is a connecting rod, and this is a slider. Okay, and this, when this crank is rotated, as per the rotation of the crank, this slider is moves along a straight line. Means here the if when we give the input to the crank, the rotary motion is converted into the reciprocating motion. Okay, so here we use the three positions of the slider crank mechanism. Here, what is mean by three position? They given that theta. Theta is the initial position of the crank. Initial position of the crank. Theta 1, 2 is second position of the crank. Means this is an angle. If we consider this is the first position of the slider, then this is the theta. Okay. Then this angle is theta 1, 2, and this angle is theta 1, 3. Okay. So here theta 1, 3 is the third position of the crank. Then S12 is given. S12 is the, if we consider this is the first position of the slider, okay, and if this is the second position of the slider, then distance between these two is the S12, displacement between first and second position of the slider, and S13 is the displacement between first and third position of the slider. Okay, so these things are given in our numerical or in our problem statement, and they will ask to find out the length of the connecting rod, okay, by using a relative pore method. So first of all, we will discuss how this method is used for find out the length of the remaining part or position of the crank. Okay, so first of all, draw one horizontal line. Consider it on a point A1, that is fixed point. Okay, mark this line as a X. Then draw the one line which is passing through this point A1 and perpendicular to A1 X. Mark this line as a Y. Okay. Then, now take the point E, which is at a distance equal to, which is at a distance equal to S12/2 on this horizontal line. On this horizontal line, suppose I will mark this is a point E. Draw the one vertical line or line which is parallel to A1Y passing through E. Passing through E, and this distance is equal to S12 by 2. Okay. How we can decide that the line which is passing through E is on the left or right side of the A1? How we can decide that the line which is passing through E is on the right hand side or left hand side of the point A1? This we decide as per the rotation of the crank. Suppose
This is our slider crank mechanism, and this crank is rotating in a
anti-clockwise direction.
When this crank is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, then this slider is moves towards the point or towards this point. Suppose I will mark it as A. Then the slider will move towards the point A. Okay. And when this crank is rotating in a clockwise direction, then slider will move along away from the A. So these line we will decide on the road on the basis of rotation of the crank. Means when this crank or when this slider is moves towards the A, then direction of the E is opposite to the slider. Means when slider is moving in this direction, we have to take this E point on this direction of the A. When slider is moves towards the A, then E should be away from the A, or E should be a right hand side of the A. That's why here we consider that the crank is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. Here we consider that the crank is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. That's why we take that point E is towards the right hand side of the A1. Okay. Now draw a line which is passing through A1, which is passing through A1 and makes an angle theta 12 by 2 along this vertical line. This angle is equal to theta 1 by 2. Okay. And why we draw this line which is passing through A1? That is means this angle is the vertical line, and this line is on side of E. This is also decided on the direction of rotation of the crank. This crank is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. That's why we have taken this line, which is makes an angle theta 12 by 2 with this vertical line on this direction. It is means the direction or vector of this line is decided on the rotation of the crank. Okay, and where these two line intersects, mark this as the point R1. This is the first relative. The same procedure we have to follow. The same procedure we have to follow for theta 13 and S13. So, take another point F, which is at a distance, S13 by 2, and draw the vertical line from F. F is how we have taken that, how we decide that point F. We have decided the point F, which is at a distance S13 by 2 from the point A1. Similarly, draw one line which is passing through A1, makes an angle theta 13 by 2. This angle is theta 13 by 2, and where these two line intersect, mark this point as R2. In this way we have decided that is relative, first relative pole R1, second relative pole R2. Okay. Now measure the angle A1 R1 E. Before that, draw the initial position of the crank. Here also we require that is length of the crank. L is equal to length of crank. So, first of all, draw the initial position of the crank. Suppose, and mark this as a point B1.
how we have taken, that is length of the crank is given. So draw our line which length is equal to A1 to B1 is equal to length of the crank and which makes an angle
theta with the horizontal.
Theta with the horizontal. Okay. Now join B1 to R1. Then B1 to R2. We have joined B1 to R1 and B1 to R2. Now measure an angle A1 R1 E. Angle A1 R1 E is equal. We have to need to measure the angle A1 R1 E and draw our line which is make same angle, that is angle B1 R1 Q. B1 R1 Q.
So this is this angle and this line is Q.
We have measured the angle A1 R1 E, that is A1 R1 E, and we have drawn same angle, that is B1 R1 Q. Similarly, measure the angle A1 R2 F, and which is equal to B1 R2 S. B1 R2 S. Draw the line which is passing through R1 and R2 and along the B1 R1 and makes an angle A1 R2 F. Okay. And where these two lines intersect, mark this point as C. Mark this point as a C1. Okay, where these two lines intersect, mark this point as a C1, and here is the position of the slider. Join B1 to C1. Join B1 to C1, and the distance B1 to C1 is the length of the connecting rod. B1 to C1 is the length of the connecting rod. And if we see here, the slider at point C1, it is at some distance below this horizontal line or below this point A1. This distance is called as eccentricity. This distance is eccentricity. So in this way, we can use relative pole method for slider crank mechanism when the three position synthesis is required, or when three positions of the slider and crank mechanism is given. Then by using this graphical method or by using this procedure, we can find out the length of the connecting rod and this eccentricity. Okay, so this is the overall method for the relative pole method for a three position synthesis of slider.